Omaha. They're hoping they can get back there in a couple of weeks. That one is off the fist and will drop in for a base hit. Steven Scott will bobble the ball, and that will allow Canzone to get out to second base.
And that's what hitters do. Canzone behind in the count, one and two. Doesn't really know what he's going to get from Fellows. Knight.
Injured early this season. Actually, on opening day, missed the non-conference season. Now back up to 100%. Ground ball. Infante will scoop. Nobody's there to cover first, and the run will score. Canzone will touch home, and Ohio State off to a 1-0 lead. Team against a freshman. Against Garrett Burhan. 6-3 on the season. Line right back up the middle. Austin Martin, first pitch he sees, back up the middle. He's now reached base in 28 straight. Player of the year. Has reached base in 86 of his last 87 games. Hammered down the right field line. That will bounce over the wall for a ground rule double. The 13th double of the year for J.J. Blade.
Well, Ohio State catches a break here. If that ball hits the wall, Austin Martin scores. Instead, he has to stop at third base on the ground rule double. But what can this kid not do? He goes the other way with the best of them. He can pull it. He's got great situational and pitch sequence etiquette at the plate. I mean, this guy is really, really good. He can barrel it up for home runs. Watch Austin Martin scooting around second on his way to third. Again, he's got to go back because of the ground.
Freshman All-American when he hit 305. Off the fist, slow roller. That's going to get a run home, and that'll be the first out of the inning, and Blade is at third base.
Well, great job by Ethan Paul. The pitch before Burhan buried it on the inside. And Ethan Paul still staying back, gets the same pitch and jams himself, but gets the job done, gets the runner over to less than two outs.
Little blooper, is that going to drop in? Long run for Canzone, it will drop in. And J.J. Blade will score the Commodore's second run of the game.
A little bit of a tough jump in center field for Winan, but good hitters get jammed. We saw Canzone do it. Dingler did it for Ohio State. Right here with two outs, Pat DeMarco gets jammed, pops.
Champs, the Missouri Valley Tournament champs, Big Ten and SEC champs. Oh, that ball is cussed. Connor Pohl just nails it. It just left the stadium. Wow.
Yeah, that one was hit. My goodness. 1-0 fastball with nobody on. As a hitter, you know a fastball's coming. It's center cut for Drake Fellows, and Connor Pohl lit that one up. Look at the location of this 1-0 fastball from Drake Fellows, just trying to get a strike. He elevates it a little too much, and watch out in the dugout because that bat's coming.
His sixth home run of the year ties it up for the junior. That left the stadium. Three home runs in his last eight games. Chalk up eight runs batted in as well. And we are tied at two as we move to the bottom of the second inning. Steven Scott, first pitch he sees out to left. Cherry on the run. Can't get it. It's going to go all the way to the wall. Scott will round second. He's on his way to third. Here comes the throw, and it will be cut off.
Well, we've seen this all day, and I'm not standing out there, but the outfielders are having a tough time picking up the baseball. Cherry was a little hesitant on charging this ball, decides to go, and that's what happens when you miss it all the way to the wall in a leadoff triple for Steven Scott. But we've seen all these outfielders be a little hesitant on balls like that, and they're letting them drop in front of you. Cherry elects to go after it, and that's hard to beat here in Nashville.
First three-ball count of the night for Garrett Burhan. High in the air to left. Cherry will make the catch, and that will get the run home. And the Commodores reclaim the lead at 3-2 as Steven Scott touches home plate. Well, this Vandy offense, we talked about it. I mean, obviously it's highlighted by Martin and Blade because of their prowess at the plate. But overall, this team has swung it with the best of them. Look at these numbers and where they rank nationally. The 82 home runs, best in the conference, but seventh.
Like you said, he's really struggled after that big sophomore year.
Yeah, 315 as a sophomore with 11 homers and 16 doubles. He's hit just 10 home runs over the last 2 years. You can make that 11 home runs in the last 2 years. Bye-bye baseball, and Fonte makes it a 4-2 game.
Did I say something about swinging through fastballs? He didn't miss that one right there. That's a 9-hole, folks. Julian Infante. Again, 11 home runs his sophomore year, and when he catches it, he really does. That's a big kid, and blasted that ball out to left center. Burhan ahead in the count. Look where this fastball is located, just right down center cut highway. And Julian Infante puts a charge into it. He knew it right away. Look how fired up his teammates are for him.
Ground ball, scooped up there by Carpenter. Nice play, but that'll get a run on. So Duvall hits it to the right side of the infield, and that gets DeMarco home, and it's now 5-2 Vanderbilt.
That's the toughest play a second baseman's going to have to make, moving to your right side against the grain and having to glove that on the other side.
Here comes the run home. As it hits Steven Scott, he will score, and it's now 6-2.
Now Burhan just chokes this fastball into the dirt. Dingler not able to handle it. Kind of tries to backstab it instead of getting down and really trying to block that ball.
Pat DeMarco. There's ball four. Well, there's odds on who is going to. Steven Scott, fly ball out to left. That is deep, and it is off the wall, right off the corner. Here comes the throw home, and that'll get the seventh run home for the Commodores. Steven Scott. If that's about a foot to the right, it's out of here.
Told you how hot he's been over the last eight games. 13 for 28 with five home runs coming into this game. And that is the weirdest double I've ever seen. That ball was hammered out to left field. Hits the left big wall. Then comes down and hits the side smaller wall. Watch this ricochet. The big wall, then the side wall, and ricochets back.
High chopper, and that's going to sneak in for a base hit, maybe two. And Martin will get there.
Well, hitters just get hits. They don't draw pictures in the scorebook. And for Austin Martin, just bounces it off this turf. I mean, look how high that ball jumps. It's a routine out on natural grass, but he knows how to play at home. And watch him sprint right out of the box. He smells a double right away. Right foot on the inside part of the bag, and here he goes. All the way into second base for a double.
Smash down the line, base hit. That'll get Martin in, and J.J. Blade with the double, his second today. He has reached base four times, two doubles and two walks.
We talked about his ability to go the other way. What's impressive about this kid with 26 home runs and the power that he has, he's not always looking to pull it. Here he gets a ball out over the outside part of the play. They tried to keep it down and low, but it was actually a decent pitch on the outside corner. Dingler calling for it, and look at the shake of the head and the bullet down the left field line for J.J. Bleda. They're running through the gauntlet here in this Vanderbilt lineup. Double by Austin Martin, double by J.J. Bleda, and now 3-4-5 coming up.
Between Martin and Bleda, they've reached base seven times tonight. Pretty good year for the stash. Oregon State and Cincinnati on ESPNU right now. For those of you looking for the defending national champs. Down in the dirt, strikeout, complete game. The second of the season for Drake Fellows. He goes to 12-0 on the season. And Vanderbilt beats Ohio State 8-2.
What a gutsy performance from Drake Fellows tonight. Ran through the Ohio State lineup four times. Gives up seven hits and all those.